I've been bad coaching at the University of Michigan the last 4 years. And prior to that, I wrestled in college. I wrestled for the University of Michigan. I grew up in the state of Illinois. And some of you Florida guys actually was friends with Mike Palazzo in high school. We were in the same grade, knew each other all through high school. After college, I competed and wrestled for the U.S. and internationally for about 5 years. And then I opened a wrestling club in the Chicagoland area called Overtime School Wrestling. I did that for about 12 years. Very similar to the layout here. And we trained all different age groups year-round, folkstyle, freestyle. And really enjoyed that. It was great. Love working with the younger age groups, as well as the college age. But I'm going to work some front headlock and short offensive position with you guys today. We don't have a lot of time, so I'm going to try to move pretty quick. I'm going to try to get through about four or five of the positions. Really focus on learning how to win that position, okay? I was very fortunate. I started to really learn this position and have a great appreciation for it, actually right after college. I had a lot of success with it. High school and college, but I started really learning the position after college. I was training at Foxcatcher, and I was doing some training with Dave Schultz for about 2 years off and on in both camps. And he was my size, so I wanted to wrestle a lot. He had a tremendous front headlock and short offense series. I was very fortunate to pick that up from him, and so it's something, for me, I always try to pass down to the younger age groups. I think it's an important position. I think, too, in high school, you're starting to see a trend, too, where, you guys are probably seeing a lot of your opponents sometimes at different points in the match, they're wrestling down on one knee. Either to start a match or when they're spaced, or maybe they're a headlock point, they're shorter time on the clock, they're down on the knee. And you got to be able to pack that head, pack down on the knee. You got to be able to close that gap, put pressure on him, and you're probably going to have to pack that head to get to his legs or create some offense. Okay? So we're just going to spend time working right in the position. You guys have been wrestling for a while, so there's a lot of different ways to get there, off your snap downs or off their shot, or off that guy, wrestling down on the knee. But we're just going to start in a position, and we'll start with basically a certain sequence I want you to think about. Mentality's got to be on attacking the position. All right, there's a lot of ways to score from front head and short offense, a lot of ways to get to their legs, a lot of ways to put them in their back, but you've got to have the mentality you're attacking the position. Okay, guys that don't have a lot of success there, they hold the weight out front. Okay, kind of catch the position or snap and then hold. And they give a guy time to get a good strong base, start chewing up their elbows, start screening an angle for themselves. Okay, you don't want to do that. You got to have the mentality you're going to attack the position. Okay? So, here's you. Yeah, so in this position, one thing you want to think about, a lot of times your shoulder position is going to start at the base of that neck, okay? But I want to move my shoulder to the side I'm attacking. I want to kind of half this guy, train an angle so that I can get to his leg, get backside on the score, okay? So think about when you start in this position, shoulder on the base of that neck. I want to keep that hand on the chin. I want to keep that elbow really short, keep that arm short, keep that elbow high, okay? But as I start to attack the position, I'm going to bounce this guy and start to try to create an angle. I want to slide my shoulder in the base of the neck and get shoulder to shoulder with him. Okay? Hard to get around, hard to get good angle with my back and my shoulder on his back. Okay? So I got to create that angle. Arms are short. Okay? As I bounce this guy, a lot of that's coming from my hips. It's like a level change from the mat. Sinking my hips, a little bit of timing to it. As I bounce that guy, it's going to slow him down, keep that weight on his hands, elbow, head. Ideally, I want to get him on that elbow and on his forehead. I keep a lot of weight on this arm. Because in order to get here, I got to beat this arm. Right? So that quick bounce, watch how I slide my shoulder on that bounce. I'm shoulder to shoulder with him. Okay? I didn't leave my shoulder here when I did it. Cool. Bounce, slide that shoulder. I'm trying to get back so I can get to that hamstring. Okay? Elbow stays down. Off that knee, I'm going to run on this hamstring. As I run, I'm going to slide, shift my weight forward, bring this elbow down on the other side. Because I don't want him to be able to wrestle into me. I want to keep this, driving this head away. I turn my hips so I can run everything forward and run this guy into the mat. Okay? Get to a riding position. Okay? So again, it's the timing. I'm going to put his head where my knee was.
changing levels with my hips. My arms don't do a lot of moving here. Shorten up that back elbow so he can't get to that arm. Okay. Bounce him. Maybe take one or two. I'm trying to get that angle and get backside. Get to that hamstring. Shoulder is so important. Okay. Again. Hamstring. Up quick. The important part is I don't stay here. This is when guys can kind of wrestle into you and start to turn in you. Starts to come up off those hands. I want, as soon as I get that hamstring, I shift those hips. Get my toes going the other direction. Keep that pressure down that head. Okay? Get your riding position. Okay? How many freestylers? Any freestylers in here? Freestyle, full style, probably equal to core. What I don't want to do right when I get here, I don't want to stay on this knee. I want to be up on those toes. Here. Turn those hips. Okay? Don't drop this knee. Stay up. Keep that weight. Drive with those legs. Run that back into the mat. Okay? Questions? Let's work this first position. Sets of three. Go.